How's it going, my orangutan gang? Lachlan here, and this is my project I've been working on lately. And here it is, my top 18 Pokemon types. Now, this is 100% opinionated, and it's completely my love for the type. I'll be covering Pokemon in the type, stats, moves, and usability in battle to me, and just overall designs and nostalgia and just amazement of the type. So let's just start this really quickly. Coming in at number 18 for me is the Rock type. Alright guys, so to me, the Rock type is a absolutely confusing type. I always seem to get confused with Ground type. I'm not sure if that's me, or if they're too similar, or if they're just built that way. And I kind of wish they were made into an Earth type and joined together. So if my voice does sound a bit weird, it's 6:48 in the morning and I've got a concert to go to at 9. So I thought, better get this video out. Now, the Rock type is an extremely defensive type. However, most of its weaknesses use special moves. And the Rock type doesn't have any special defense whatsoever to support it. Most of these Pokemon have terrible to meh designs. Some of these horrible Pokemon are the Geodude family, which include Geodude, Graveler, Golem, the Cradilly line, which kind of just look weird and don't look kind of like a Pokemon, they just look weird. And the Tortuga line, due to it being 4 times weak to grass and the design not being overly creative. And I need to mention Shuckle. To me, Shuckle is kind of a gimmick Pokemon. I know there's that move they added in Gen 4 to swap its attack and defense, but I still find it a gimmick, and I've only had a few Shuckles, but they're really not meant for me. Well, I'm sorry if I offended any of you, but this is my opinion. Now to move on to number 17. Now this is going to be quite a bit of a shock to you. In number 17 is the Dragon type. In my opinion, the Dragon type is way overrated due to every pseudo-legendary besides Metaghost and Tyranitar being part or fully Dragon. It takes forever to make these Pokemon evolve. This is just sort of a gimmick with the type, maybe to make them underpowered at the very beginning. But even then, like, they're still pretty powerful, but sort of broken too. They're weak to their own type, which is extremely stupid. Their stats are extremely unbalanced due to it being based on attack and special attack. So as soon as it's hit with a Dragon type, or Ice type attack, or a Fairy type attack, and the fairies are immune to it, it's pretty much doomed. And almost every mascot legendary is part dragon. Are you trying to tell us we can't have a poison type legendary, Game Freak, because you love your dragons so much? Now, these designs are really cool. I'll admit the dragon type has really, really cool designs, like Haxorus, Garchomp, Hydreigon, Zekrom, but the designs are pretty much the only redeeming factor about the Dragon type, and unfortunately that's really sad. I think if they didn't take forever to evolve and maybe had some stat arrangement, I might like it, but I don't know, maybe, I doubt that'll happen, but... Now moving on to one of the most broken types, especially in Generation 1, if that description wasn't a dead giveaway, coming in number 16, is the psychic type. The psychic type. Oh, where do I begin with this thing? Oh, I know. The most overrated and broken type, besides Dragon, in Generation 1, it was way more overpowered than Dragon. Due to there being no dark type to, like, counter it, the Ghastly line being part poison, making psychic type moves super effective against it, and having no good bug type Pokemon or attacks, it was way overpowered. Psychic, however, does have a sliver, notice the word sliver, of positives. It has a genius type weakness, being common fears, ghosts, the dark, and bugs. And they do have pretty decent moves to muck with you, such as Trick Room, Trick, Ally Switch, and Gravity, while having Calm Mind to increase its already incredible special attack. And do I even need to mention the legendaries? However, the only designs I like are the legendaries. Mega Mewtwo X, Mew, Mewtwo. Deoxys, Lugia, Victini, and Latios and Latias. The rest of the designs are meh, god awful. 15 is probably one of the more overlooked types, but it's still not great. Coming in at number 15, we have the poison type. Now, I just want to note, I don't hate the previously mentioned types, they're just not my favorite, and some I don't really, really like at all because of reasons. However, I think poison has really cool designs, like from the sneaky death frog known as Toxicroak to the deadly but stinky skunk tank. I personally think the poison type got well-deserved attention in Generation 4 because of this, due to there not being many good poison types out there. In Generation 4, we got some amazing, amazing poison types. There are only three of them, but they were really good and still are probably the best ones. The previously mentioned Toxicroak, Skunk Tank, and a Pokemon with a very unique typing, Drapion, which has Dark Poison. I only really have two main gripes with this type, being its lack of super effective type coverage, but it did give Fairy a well-needed weakness, and mainly their attack aren't all that powerful. That's about all I've really got to say. The designs are cool, and their moves aren't that great, but, you know, it's not the worst type. Now, I've got to say, number 14 might make you quake in your boots. No pun intended. But coming in at number 14 is the ground type. From now on, the types I like or adore. The ground type is very similar to the rock type, being defensively based. They have pretty good designs. Some I really enjoy are Golurk, Crocodile, Donphan, Sandslash, Gliscor, and the newly legendary Zygarde. These have amazing designs. The ground type is well known for Earthquake, which is a move with 100 base power and 100% accuracy, which is very reliable at times, and flying types are immune to it, making it really good if you have a flying type with it, you in a double battle. However, besides that move, there aren't a lot of memorable moves, except for Sand Tomb. These Pokemon are really great to stall. They can take a fair bit of a beating, but as soon as they're hit by a special attack, they're gone. Just kiss them bye-bye. Say bye-bye. I love you. Bye. However, it's super effective against our next type. Our first starter type, the fire type. The fire type seems to be the most popular of choices when you go to look at starter Pokemon. Look at all Pokemon videos and you will see, like for Charizard, like for Blaziken. However, this type is weak to water, rock, and ground, which are all extremely common types. But it's one of the few types that can make it hard to send out a steel type. I personally don't like many of the designs except for Macargo and Torkoal, however. No, I'm not being a fire Nazi. I just like the turtles. Shut up. If you're new to Pokemon, I recommend this type as your starter choice, though, as it is kind of the difficulty. Fire being easy, water being normal, and grass being hard. I recommend this type, and some of the designs are cool, but not a lot, and, yeah. Now, coming in at number 12 is, sorry to shock you, but the electric type only made it to number 12 and didn't crack my top 10. But I do have a valid reason, okay? You ready for this? Are you ready? It's because the glass cap. Now, I'm gonna just say straight off the bat, I don't have a lot to kind of explain why the electric type is here. I just kind of think it deserves to sit here. The only thing about them is they're really hard to kill, because a lot of these are part flying, and that means they can avoid ground, one of their major weaknesses, or they have magnet rise, or you've given them an air balloon, and they're just really hard to kill. However, there are a few electric types I really enjoy. These are Zapdos, Electivire, Raikou, Manectric, Galvantula, and a hidden gem in my opinion, Lantern. These Pokemon are all great. However, I do think the electric type is overpowered still, even though they only have the one weakness. Especially Lieutenant Surge, because like he kicks so much butt. And due to me not overly liking the ground type, they're a huge pain to fight. Well, I'm glad that's out the way now. Sorry if I offended you or anything, and I'm sorry that I'm gonna have to burst your bubble, but water only made it to number 11 and just missed out on my top 10. The water type. The water type has an average base stat total of 416, with pretty well-rounded stats, except for speed, which doesn't overly matter in a Pokemon battle. Now, there are a few things wrong with this type due to there being 4 freaking HMs based on it, meaning you must always have at least one water type during your journey. And to be honest, there aren't a lot of water types I like. However, they're not a bad type, only having 2 weaknesses of electric and grass. And due to these not being overly common types, you're pretty safe. And if some Pokemon neutralizing the weakness to electricity, such as Swampert, Quagsire, Gastrodon, Pelipper, and Seismitoad. However, this does give them a 4 times weakness to grass, so it comes to personal preference with your weakness choice. Now, the water type is the most common type, which isn't a bad thing, but it doesn't make it a huge, oh my god, I got a ghost type Pokemon. The only water type I really like are Gorbius, the previously mentioned Lantern, Ludicolo, and Crawdon. Now, before you go, really like Gen 3 water types, the reason? Because they made them really, really good in Gen 3, and I didn't grow up with it either. Plus, when they were introduced to the physical special split in Gen 4, Crawdon was so good. Like, it was the karate crustacean. It would whoopee your ass. Now, this might kind of sound painful, but number 10 is as painful as having a Hitmonlee kick you right in the junk. The fighting type only, and I mean just scraped into my top 10. Nonetheless, I still love the type. The fighting type is a very basic type. What's the strategy? Pungle kick the opponent until it dies. I mean, faint, stupid. The fighting type is a base stat total of 441. With outstanding attack and meh stats everywhere else. This doesn't make it a bad type. This type may have the weakness of Fairy, Flying, and Psychic, but it has really good strengths towards these types. Rock, Steel, Ice, Duck, and who could forget, Sucky Normal type. I recommend having a Fighting type to take down Rock and Steel type due to them having extremely high defenses. However, a Water type move on a Rock and a Fire type for a Steel due to them both having atrocious special defense, but an Aura Sphere is just as good in my opinion. At least this type isn't as common, but it's not impossible to find a Steel. However, this type can't touch a ghost, but there are some really cool designs to make up for that. Some of these are Sork, Heracross, Infernape, Breloom, who could forget Toxicroak, and Chestnut. This type is overall a good Pokemon type, but you've just got to be a little bit careful not to let it get hurt too bad. And is it just me, or do they have a lack of stat boosting moves? Now, to move on to about everyone's least favorite type, the normal type. Oh, he put it there, damn. That's right, you know it. The normal type, in my eyes, is way better than your little dragon, son. The normal type has an overall base stat total of 393. However, that's not what takes the cake for me. The normal type only has one weakness and has an immunity to ghost, and only does half damage to rock and steel, which is pretty normal for most Pokemon. This type's 2 best stats are attack and HP, which isn't great. However, the main thing that puts this type on top is the Pokemon. In the category, Tauros, Chansey, Aipom, Slaking, which has the highest stat of all non-legendary Pokemon, Snorlax, with its huge, massive defense, Swordsbuck, pretty much being the only physical grass type, and need I mention Miltank. Now, there have been a few gym leaders who have been based around the normal type, but I don't think one's as popular as Whitney from Goldenrod City in Johto, and her Miltank. However, she was never a real challenge to me. She was forgettable and easy to demolish for me. So overall, a good reliable type with not too many weaknesses. Now, this might be the part that freezes you in your tracks. Number 8 is the Ice type. The Ice type is very similar to the Electric type, but has more strengths and weaknesses. This type has been well known as the Dragon Killer. This type is a bigger glass cannon than the Electric type, but has some more interest to me. I like freezing my enemies to death in like a frozen state, then stopping their heart of jolts of electricity. I can already do that in real life. I'm not a crazy man. The S-type has a very interesting stats, with an average base stat total of a decent 449, and its two strongest stats being special attack and special defense. They're meant to be a slower sort of special sweeper, in my opinion, but with a bit of special defense to back it up, you can make it work so it doesn't die instantly. But any physical, fighting, fire, rock, or steel type move will guarantee death, or bring you down to really low health. This type has really cool designs, except for Delibird. Some of these cool Pokemon being Articuno, Mamoswine, Froslass, Weavile, Kyurem, and its three forms, and last but not least, the Yeti himself, Abomasnow. These Pokemon all have really cool typing, having a unique typing, except for Articuno, who shares its type with... Say it with me, everybody! Delibird. So let's recap. The Ice type is a more powerful version of the Electric type, with cooler designs, and it's kind of more powerful to more things. Yeah, I don't mean to spook you, but coming in at number 7 is the Ghost type. The Ghost type is the least common type, only having 34 Pokemon, including Mega Evolutions. This means fighting a Ghost type is a bit of a pain, but the reward is so worth it. The Ghost type has an average base stat total of 426, and their best stats being Special Attack and Special Defense. Overall, they're meant to be Special Sleepers, however there are a few exceptions such as Bennett, Dusknoir, Gorgeous, and Trevenant. These are physical sleepers, and they are my favourite Ghost type Pokemon. The Ghost type has 7 physical moves and 4 special moves, so I recommend a physical Ghost type preferably Trevenant, due to it being a possessed tree, plus they just look amazing. Number 6 is the most offensive type known to Pokemon Trainer. It was introduced in Generation 2. Number 6 is the Steel type. The Steel type. Where to begin? How about its average base stat total of 471, with its best stat being defense? They are meant to be a wall, which means taking damage well and hitting back with something super effective. These Pokemon have really, really cool designs and unique typing. Some of these Pokemon include Steelix, Aggron, Dialga, Magnezone, Aegislash, and Ferrothorn. These Pokemon just look badass and have decent defense, except for Ferrothorn, being a 4x weakness to fire. I can't really describe much else why I like the Steel type, I just do. They're really defensive and can do a decent amount of damage back. And their designs are really, really cool. Now, a lot of you might see this as a bit of a shock that this type made it this high on my list. Number 5, having the worst base stat total ever, is the Bug type, and it made my top 5. The Bug type. Where do I begin? Oh, I know. Amazing designs. These Pokemon have really cool designs, such as Yanmega, freaking Volcarona, Galvantula, Heracross, Scizor, Ariados. These Pokemon all have really cool designs and are special in their unique way. Yanmega's ability is Speed Boost, which boosts its speed by 1 per turn it's in battle. Volcarona has a unique typing of Bug Fire. Galvantula also has a unique typing of Bug Electric, and it has a signature move called Electroweb. And everyone's talked about Scizor and Heracross, so I'm not going to bother. However, I don't hear people give Ariados much praise, when it really deserves it, in my opinion. It's the distinctive Bug type, being a spider which scares the pants off everyone. So in total, this type isn't as bad as it looks, has some really good moves, has really unique typings which help cover its weaknesses. Now, this type is so underrated, and probably everyone's least favourite starter type, but to me, it's number 1, except for 3 others that beat it. Coming in at number 4 is the Grass type. The Grass type. The Grass type has an average base stat total of 410. Now, this might seem and sound terrible, but when fully evolved, its overall stats can reach nearly 500. No, not 9,000 like you were going to think. Which is really good. The Grass type has the most diverse type of Pokemon to work with. It could be an Anoa with Poison Powder, Spore, Dream Eater, and Leech Seed. To keep gaining health back, you could be a physical sweeper with moves such as Leaf Blade, Nidalarm, Petal Blizzard, and Wood Hammer. Or you could get a special sweeper with moves such as Solar Beam, Giga Drain, Frenzy Plant, and Energy Ball. It also holds my favorite starter of all time, Treecko. It's just an amazing type with a handful of weaknesses. And need I mention it resists the electric type? Now, to wrap this type up, I'm going to show you some really cool designs. Sceptile, Superior, Carnivine, Venusaur, Shiftry, Breloom. To recap, you can build a grass type any way you want with devastating results on the battlefield. And some of you might be shocked that the newest type, which I haven't used much, can make it all the way to number 3. So coming in at number 3 is the fairy type. That's right, damn fairies are back. OMG, this Pokemon type was needed. Dragon types were overpowered. If you didn't have an ice type, the fairy type is what you need. The fairy type has an average base stat total of 384, which might sound terrible, but remember, this Pokemon type is new and doesn't have a lot of Pokemon stats to average. Sadly, this Pokemon has 5 special attacks and one physical type move. They are really good, the fairy type, though. They gave poison and extra strength. This type also is immune to dragon, is super effective against dragon, and is just so cool. Some of my favorite fairy types are Togekiss, Xerneas, Florges, and Mega Marwile. So, let's recap. Fairy type was much needed, has the same amount of Pokemon as Ghost, and has really cool designs, but needs more physical moves. Now, number 2 comes sweeping down on you, and no more walking is a very iconic thing about this type. Number 2 on this list is the flying type. The flying type, clocking at an average base stat total of 435, which is mainly based in attack and speed. But is that all the flying type has working for it? No. The flying type has a huge amount of Pokemon associated with it, and it's been paired up with every type. Some of my favorite designs and typings are Aerodactyl, Zapdos, Articuno, and Moltres. Crobat, my favorite legendary of all time, Ho-Oh, and the defensive as heck Terrigakiss. Flying type has a move full of 11 physical moves. Some of my favorite of these are Brave Bird and Aerial Ace, especially Aerial Ace from the anime. This type also has 7 special attack moves. Some of these are Lugia's signature move, Aeroblast, and Hurricane, which is not Lugia's exclusive move. And my main reason for liking the flying type is I love birds. My grandfather is a huge bird fan, and I think that's been moved on to me. Now, due to the process of elimination, you should all know what number 1 is, but if you didn't, it's... Wait for it. Dark type. Yes, that's right. The dark type is my favorite type of Pokemon. This type is amazing. They are so cool. And their moves are amazing. And okay. And they just kick butt in battle. Alright, fanboy moment over. The dark type clocks in at an average base stat total of 430. Majority of it being based in attack. But that doesn't mean they can't take a few hits. To help with this, developers at Game Freak made a lot of Dark-type physical, such as Absol, Weavile, Scrafty, and they also gave them some really cool moves, such as Beat Up, Bite, Crunch, and my favorite Dark-type move, Night Slash. This doesn't mean that you can't have a special attack-based Dark-type, however. Just look at Zoroark and Houndoom. They can have the most signature Dark-type move, in my opinion, Dark Pulse. Now to where it really starts to heat up. I love the Dark-type designs, such as Houndoom, Zoroark, Absol, Darkrai, Shiftry, Crawdon. The list goes on. But to summarize it, they kick butt in battle, and they're just amazing. Their designs are beautiful. They have really cool moves. They've built perfectly, and yeah. The Dark-type is my favorite Pokemon type. Thanks for watching, guys. This has been my top 18 Pokemon types. I can't believe you've made it to the end of the video. This is going to be the longest video I've ever made. Don't forget to like, share, comment, all of that stuff. And don't forget to subscribe to the Orangutan Gang. And thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.